According to a World Bank report, a 10% increase in broadband penetration in developing countries such as Nigeria could boost economic growth by as much as 1.3%. Now, recognizing the huge opportunity this presents for investors, the U.S. Trade and Development Agency supporting broadband with funding to help broadband connectivity between Lagos and Port Harcourt. Funke Okweke, Chief Executive Officer of Main One, joins me now to tell us more about this. Thank you so much, Funke, for your time. Talk us through what this grant is about and what how it's going to be used in one case operation.
The grant is towards the feasibility study for the extension of our cable from Lagos to Port Harcourt, as you mentioned. Port Harcourt, as you know, is part of the producing region in the southern part of the country, in the Niger Delta. We left our cable here with the rest of the world in 2010, but have faced a high cost trying to move the capacity down the cable into the world. And so, extension to this one we're looking at would help us significantly reduce the price of getting the top and south and southeast or pushing region. From Lagos to Port Harcourt, our prices are between Lagos and London, and we believe it's the exact to spice.
How much
$500 is towards the visit. We study which technical permitting and legal. Regulatory issues as well as commercial issues should be treated within give us sufficient information to put a definitive development plan and strategy for the complex.
Any plans between the Port Lake and any plans to expand other on Nigeria?
Well, definitely the hub across the southeast and south parts of the country. So the ones have access through Port Harcourt. We can not open there is a commission we have other estates available. We are working with them to try to extend services into surrounding states. Beyond that, in Africa, we have also extended services directly into Benin, Togo, Burkina Faso, and with build to Port Harcourt, we're also looking at potential Cameroon.
What challenges do you see along the way, and are you prepared?
The challenges in the extension of Port Harcourt is a very operationally intense area with a lot of oil blocks and oil operation. The rest is necessary, so we have to do it. Unless we believe this is a project that is a community where economic growth and for the government in terms of policy direction, we believe we will be able to line up adequate support and protection to successfully complete.
We're looking to future grants, but 7 years and it's with but looking to seek grants elsewhere, or do you think
this would only help us do the development or the preliminary work to actually build build like this runs into the tens of millions of dollars, and we will be seeking additional funding straight investment agreements from companies, governments in the region, as well as taking some additional debt to actually complete the project.
Now, of course, we're very aware of the federal government's 5-year broadband plan. Now, we know that's still in early stages, implementation stage, but your expectations going forward, how do you expect to tie in what, your own strategies for ensuring that at the end of the day, they have better access to broadband at affordable prices? concerns?
I think this initial extension to part or the absence of any international connectivity into the southeast region of Nigeria is one of the gaps identified in the broadband plan. So we believe the fact that maybe one is actually stepping forward to try to close the gap, and that we are getting support to do that from the UPDA is something that would be welcomed by the federal government, and we certainly hope that they would lend their support as we move forward in ensuring the project can be successfully completed.
Now, in terms of the impact on the economy, obviously, you know, it's very key for national development if we have, you know, deeper broadband penetration. We've seen what the impact could be for the Nigerian economy. Your take on the next 2, 3, 4 years, how much of the broadband base will change?
If you look back 2 years and you see what has happened, I would say access has broadened considerably. Prices have come down, not sufficiently. I think the quality and volumes of information people are able to receive is still somewhat constrained. I would expect for the next 2 years, as this kind of infrastructure gets deployed to get services around the country, that those services certainly would improve in quality, about the same price to retail consumers or less. And that you can already see a lot of business now migrating online. We have online banking, we have online retail, new business models coming up. So we certainly see a lot of service jobs created in the economy that would be dependent on doing business online.